Namaste friends, today we are going to discuss about DNA fingerprinting. First let's see the definition. DNA fingerprinting is a technique used for identification by extracting and identifying the base pair pattern of an individual's DNA. Here base pair, you know, AT and GC. This pattern of bands formed is unique in every individual. Okay, it is unique. You need to keep this in mind. Okay, and the definition you can also see is, it is a process of comparison of DNA from different sources to establish the identity. Okay, and this DNA fingerprinting is also called as DNA typing, DNA profiling, and genetic fingerprinting. Next we'll see tandem repeats. It's a sequence of two or more DNA base pairs that is repeated in such a way that repeats lie adjacent to each other on the chromosome. It is generally associated with non-coding DNA. There'll be variation in number of times DNA sequences repeat. Next we'll see repetitive DNA. Repetitive DNA is a part of DNA containing same sequence of nitrogenous bases repeated several times in tandem. During density gradient centrifugation, repetitive DNA is separated from bulk genomic DNA. This bulk genome DNA forms the major peaks, and other small peaks are called satellite DNA. The satellite DNA are part of repetitive DNA, which has long repetitive sequences in tandem. These satellite DNA do not code for any proteins, but they have large proteins. They are the basis, they are forming the basis for DNA fingerprinting. These show high degree of polymorphism. This satellite DNA is of two types. One is microsatellite, another one is mini satellites. These mini satellites are all called VNTR. VNTR is abbreviated as variable number of tandem repeats. These micro satellites are all called STR, short tandem repeats or simple sequence repeats. Now we'll see various steps involved in DNA fingerprinting. First, collection of sample, that is a minute amount of blood, semen or air bulb or any other body cells are collected. From this, DNA is isolated or extracted from the cells. And next is, DNA is amplified in volume by polymerase chain reaction. Then DNA is cut into fragments using restriction endonucleases. Next, separation of DNA fragments were made into pass-through electrophoresis. These are visualized with the help of a dye. Then, double-stranded DNA is cut into single-stranded DNA with the use of alkaline chemicals. Okay. Next, blotting or transferring of separated DNA fragments to synthetic membranes such as nitrocellulose or nylon. Then, nylon sheath is immersed in a bath where probes or markers are added. These markers nothing but the radioactive synthetic DNA segments of known sequence will be added. Thus, the probe hybridizes VNTR. You know what is VNTR? Variable number of tandem repeats. X-ray film is exposed to this nylon sheath, which gives dark bands at the probe site. What is probe site? Radioactive site. Thus, hybridized fragments are detected using autoradiography. This DNA fingerprinting helps in identifying biological father, true biological father, legal issues, identification of criminals in rape, murder and theft cases, and solving the problems of evolution.